You're not real. Yeah, yeah.
Because the British people have had enough of waiting. The time has come
for the rule of six. Yeah.
Yo, what is up, Celiog? As my good friend Boris Johnson just said, this is the rule of six with myself, Luke Ball, and
Joe Camp. Oi, Luke, tell me, isn't that introduction hard?
Hard introduction.
Isn't that hard?
And to top it off, we got such a lovely man on it as well.
Oh, yeah, exactly. You never thought you'd see Boris Johnson and Skeptic together, but we've done it. We're taking steps forward. Both of them lovely men, especially Boris. He has to go, blood. But before we get too political, Luke, it's been a week since your operation.
It has, exactly a week.
Tell me how you're feeling.
Not bad. I'm off the meds now. Starting to get back to normality.
You say that codeine had you tripping?
When I was off the juice, yeah, codeine had me tripping.
There we go.
For sure. But now, I'm just chilled out, getting back to normal life. I was in the shower earlier and one of my plasters, plasters came off.
Yeah.
And basically, the new procedure for an appendix operation, they do a keyhole surgery, and I assume they've gone through to get my appendix underneath my belly button.
Yeah.
And it's left like a little smiley face scar.
Yeah, I can see that.
Hello.
And the belly button.
But the belly button is an issue. It looks a bit different to what it was before I went into the operation.
Do you know what I'd say? I'd say it's less of a button and more of just a slit.
A slit.
Yeah.
Go for the slit.
Yeah.
Stylish. Look, I'm gonna have to live with it. There's not much I can do now.
You can't.
I'm pretty sure they went through my belly button to put a camera through it. Is that pretty, like, how does that make you feel?
It's some good vlogging footage.
It's good vlogging footage, but it makes me cringe, man.
Check out the Rule of Six Instagram page for that.
We'll start doing vlogs.
We'll start doing appendix vlogs.
great content. But today, the topic is,
ooh, drum roll, please. Movies.
Movies. And yeah, we've got a lot of movies to... I've written down a list.
That's a huge list.
It's a big list.
Yeah.
And I'm going to have to condense it down, and we're going to have to pick the best.
Can I just say this first?
And worst, and so on and so forth. Sorry, after you.
Luke's probably watched a lot more movies than I have. He's a lot more into his movies. Obviously, I'm going to give you my opinions, but I'm also going to provoke Luke for his thoughts on different movies. He can tell me about this.
Well, you've seen a lot of these films, Joe.
I've seen a lot of them, but not all of them.
Don't put yourself down. We'll see how it goes.
We certainly will.
But before we get into it, Joe, tell me, how has your week been?
Not been too bad, mate. I had an essay due, got that over the line. So
how was that?
All good. I'm pretty happy with the effort I put in. You know, the thing is, so
solid performance.
Fairly solid performance. I started it a couple of weeks ago, so I put in the practice, put in the hours, and bang, got it over the line. I'm happy.
Did you hand it in well in advance, Joe?
It was due midday today.
Today, yeah, 12 PM today.
Yeah,
on a Tuesday, and you got it done.
I just submitted it yesterday.
On a Monday evening. That is dedication.
It is, mate.
So, anything else?
Nah, nothing.
Come on, mate. That's bang out of order.
What? I just said and done it.
Nothing. You can't tell me nothing.
By Kanye West. We interrupt this broadcast to give a quick shout out to our official Instagram page. Follow us at @the_RO6. Let me repeat that. @the_RO6 on Instagram. We've been pumping up some really nice content.
Whoa. What is going on?
Oh, it's just quickly making a shout out for Instagram for the...
No, I know exactly what you're doing.
Yeah.
Why do you keep doing this, Joe?
Well, I just thought we're getting quite a few listeners on our radio show, so if we could sort of move that traffic over onto our Instagram.
But what did we talk about last time?
Me being a clout chaser.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, like, you know, and I'm hearing as well, you're going about Celioak, trying to do shout for shout out on Instagram for our page. Like,
yeah.
What's that all about?
Once again, I thought sort of maybe if people got to know me, they'd be more inclined to follow us and interact with us.
And was that successful?
If I'm being perfectly honest, no, not really.
Look, I remember people doing that back in year 8.
Yeah, to be fair, a lot of people said they'd sort of grown out of doing that sort of thing, but...
Well, yeah. Look, I'm just disappointing you, Joe.
Look, at least I'm not posting feet pictures on OnlyFans.
What?
Well, yeah, Henry sent me a picture of your feet post that you've been putting on OnlyFans.
What are you talking about?
I feel like you know what I'm talking about, Luke.
Look, that was done in complete confidence. That is out of order. All right?
All right.
Now do your stupid plug and get on with it.
All right. Sorry, Luke. So, yeah, I guess just follow us on Instagram at the_RO6. Thank you. La, la, yeah. La, la, wait till I give my money right. I had a dream I could buy my way to heaven. When I awoke, I spent that on a necklace. I told God I'll be back in a second. Man, it's so hard not to act reckless. To whom much is given, much is tested. Get arrested, guess until he get the message. I feel the pressure under more scrutiny. And what I do, act more stupidly. Bought more jewelry, more Louis V. My mama couldn't get through to me. The drama, people suing me. I'm on TV talking like it's just you and me. I'm just saying how I feel, man. I ain't one of the Cosby's, I ain't go to hell, man. I guess the money should have changed them. I guess I should have forgot where I came from. Till I get my money right. La, la, yeah. La, la. Then you can't tell me nothing right. Excuse me, was you saying something? You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. Let up the suicide doors. This is my life, homie, you decide yours. I know that Jesus died for us, but I couldn't tell you who the side was. So I parallel double park that motherfucker sideways. Old folks talking about back in my day. But homie, this is my day. Class started 2 hours ago. Oh, am I late? No, I already graduated. And you could live through anything if magic made it. They say I talk with so much emphasis. Ooh, they so sensitive. Don't ever fix your lips like collagen to say something where you gon' end up apologizing. Let me know if it's a problem then. Alright, man, holla then. La, 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 hey. Wait till I get my money right. La, la, yeah. La, 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 then you can't tell me nothing right. Excuse me, was you saying something? You can't tell me nothing. Can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. Let the champagne splash. Let that man get cash. Let that man get past. He don't even stop to get gas. If he could move through the rumors, he could drive off of fumes, cuz. How he move in a room full of no's? How he stay faithful in a room full of. Must be the pharaohs, he in tune with his soul. So when he buried in a tomb full of gold. Treasure, what's your pleasure? Life is a depending how you dress her. So if the devil wear Prada, Adam Eve wear Nada, I'm in between, but way more fresher. But way less effort. Cause when you try hard, that's when you die hard. Your homies looking like why God when they reminisce over you, my God. La, 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 la. Wait till I get my money. You saying something? You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. La, 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 la. Wait till I get my money right. La, 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 la. Then you can't tell me nothing right. I don't live too late. That was Can't Tell Me Nothing by Kanye West. And if you don't know where that's from, Luke, can you tell me?
That song is from The Hangover.
Correct.
Arguably one of the best comedies of all time.
And that's where we're going to start. Within the category of the best movies, obviously it's quite difficult to select one singular best movie. So we've broken it down into a few little categories. Luke, quickly run me through them.
We have for best, we have Disney, funny, superhero, and then action slash thriller.
We do.
We do.
We've also got based on a true story as well.
We've got based on a true story?
Yeah.
Okay,
add it to the list, Luke.
Added to the list.
Obviously, we could have done like romantic films, could have done horrors, but me and Luke just don't really like them, if we're being honest. So sorry
I'm
to those
I can't
at home.
Do romantic films, Joe.
Yeah. Do you know what? I really don't watch many romantic films. Probably say my favourite. I'm gonna go B movie.
Romantic.
Yeah. It's the love between the B and that lady.
More like Shrek, mate.
Ooh, another good one. But either way. Where do you want to start us off, Luke? Where do you want to start us off?
Well, I believe because we just played the song from The Hangover, it's only right that we start with
comedy.
The best comedy films. And we could argue Hangover is up there. I'd also argue Step Brothers.
Yeah, strong.
Will Ferrell is unbelievably funny in that.
Yeah.
And then we have Superbad, the comedy of basically when Seth Rogen was younger, he wrote that film.
Superbad is an incredible film.
It's
Jonah Hill, good acting performance, Michael Cera,
and obviously we have Christopher Mintz-Plasse as the iconic McLovin.
McLovin.
I mean, that character itself is just hilarious.
It is a good character. So, Luke, obviously, US comedy versus English comedy. You got any ideas for UK comedy? For me,
yeah,
I love Alan Partridge. Alpha Papa would be up there as one of my top favourite UK. Also, I love
Cornetto trilogy as well.
Yeah, they're strong.
Very strong.
Strong.
From the Brits for sure.
I also like the UK Office, probably.
That's not really film.
It's got David Brent, Life on the Road.
They made into movies.
Yeah, but look, it was funny, but slightly underwhelming. I think
they
missed out on Stephen Merchant because he's very good at creating those awkward situations.
Very true.
And although Doc Brown was good in it with Ricky Gervais, it just kind of lacked a little bit of the awkwardness. Although it was quite wholesome at the end. It was a good movie. You can't knock it, but
you can't knock it.
Didn't quite hit the heights that I was expecting.
I'll actually tell you one movie that did live up to the TV series.
Yeah,
Joe.
Go on then.
That was In Between Us. The first one in particular.
Yeah.
Very good. Very
strong,
good comedy film.
Strong film. I don't know about the second one. It was a bit... I feel like they got a massive budget and they just kind of...
Not really wasted it, but they had so much more potential to...
Yeah,
to
exactly.
Make
and
funny,
I feel like...
It was still good though.
I feel like, obviously, having gone to Malia myself and sort of being able to compare my experiences to their experiences, you know, for example, the time when I had to sell all my clothes to get onto the ticket for the boat party... I could relate with that quite a lot.
Yeah, it's emotional.
It was quite emotional. And look, you would have heard about that if you listened to the Extra Time show, which is out on YouTube.
That's
now.
Very true.
Cheeky plug.
Alright, so those are all the best British comedy films.
Yeah, I'd probably say. Oh, what about Mr. Bean's Holiday?
Mr. Bean's Holiday. Oh, what, the one where he goes? He goes to Spain.
France. I want to say France.
Oh, France. Yes. Yeah. Well, he may go around Europe, but I think it is France. Yeah, it is France. Yeah, very arguably, and Johnny English too, just brief mention. But I would say my favourite comedy film has to be Borat.
Yeah, I mean, we were talking about this before and I said exactly the same thing. You've stolen it and now you put me on the spot because I look like I'm just sucking up to you now. But yeah, I think it is Borat. Like, that just created a whole sort of like culture of comedy. Like, the how much that film gets referenced is absolutely ridiculous. And do you know what? I still find it funny. Borat 2.
They made a second one as well. And I personally, a lot of people would have thought that it would not have been as good as the first one.
Yeah, I thought the second one was funny. Do you know one thing I didn't like about it? So with the first one, it was all shot very naturally, like the people were real. But I feel like in the second one, it kind of acted like the situations were naturally occurring. But there was times when it had to be an actor. It had to be like a scene.
Yeah, exactly.
Do you know what I mean? And it also was quite political.
Very political, very, very, like, very much.
Not necessarily a bad thing because, you know, Sacha Baron Cohen has that platform and he's an intelligent man. And
he's a very intelligent man. He knows how to write good comedies.
Yeah, exactly.
That's for sure.
He's using that platform to get a message across and sort of fire shots. But
so,
I said it wasn't quite as good as the first one.
So best comedy is Borat. We agree on that.
Yeah, I think I'm happy to agree on that. Other Sacha Baron Cohen
Movie's very funny as well.
Very funny.
All round, a very intelligent and a very funny man.
Right, that's comedy done. Borat, we agreed that.
Yeah.
Superhero film, Joe.
I think we're both going to agree on this pretty. It's Batman the Dark Knight.
Has to be.
Oh, I mean, Heath Ledger's acting in that is a joke. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous.
Well, he got an Oscar for it. It was only right. That is arguably the best superhero film I've ever seen. The Marvel film's good, you know, Avengers Endgame.
Do you know what?
Black Panther.
I watched Spider-Man Into the Multiverse, is that what it's called? It's on Netflix right now. Check it out.
Very good, very good.
Banging film.
Very good.
Watched that last night. And do you know what? I'd say that I preferred watching that to most superhero movies. Oh, Spider-Man. The original Spider-Man's with Tobey Maguire.
The second original Spider-Man.
They were solid. Dr.
Octopus. Spider-Man 2 with Tobey Maguire.
The one with Green Goblin as well. That used to keep me up as a kid. But once again, Spider-Man, I say, is up there, but I think it has to be The Dark Knight.
Has to be Dark Knight.
And most of that's purely just from Heath Ledger's acting. Like, I just, I'm in awe of that. Do you know what I mean? I'm in awe of it.
Right, super tick. We're going to go on to action and thriller. I'm going to say, arguably one of the best action slash thrillers for me is Django Unchained.
Yeah, incredible film.
You also have Shawshank Redemption. You also have Fight Club. Unbelievable film.
Shutter Island. The suspense in that film is incredible. Do you know what?
It keeps you guessing the whole time.
I think I've said this to you before. Yeah. I've actually still never seen the ending. I watched the entire thing through and just
the ending is so bit. I don't want to ruin it. I don't want to ruin it for
the
anyone.
Last 15 minutes. I don't know what's happened, and literally it all leads to one climax, and it's everything's like the plot's twisting.
There's one bit at the end where DiCaprio turns to Mark Ruffalo and he says this one line, and you gotta watch it, the one line, because it keeps you guessing the whole time, and he says this one line and that's how the film ends. And it's
you know what, I might
you have to watch after this, Joe.
Yeah, that's actually exactly what I was going to say. I might have to. You've sold it to me, Luke.
But I definitely say Shutter Island is definitely one of the best thrillers. You could also say, if action thriller, 1917.
Yep, strong.
Arguably
film.
One of the best films of 2020. I know it's not been amazing for films.
Was it 2020 or 2019?
It's 2020. Jeez. I'm pretty sure it's 2020.
This year has gone on for a long time.
And that was January 2020 that came out, so.
Yeah, no, incredible. I remember going to Odeon in Birmingham and watching that. Good film.
Yeah, great film. You could also argue Inglourious Basterds, and also two of the Bond films, Skyfall and Casino Royale.
Basically, the point we're making is
unbelievable.
Any Quentin Tarantino film basically fits that category.
100%.
And do you know what?
You've got action, yeah.
Do you know what? I'm actually going to say that my finito answer for the best action thriller is Kill Bill.
Kill Bill.
I love that. Especially part one. Part two is strong as well, but oh, what a film. And also, I quite like having like a female
you got seven.
Protagonist.
You've got seven. Female protagonist. Yeah, sure. I think that's exactly what Tarantino's
because there's some parts in like films when you can see they're quite clearly like virtue signaling and just chucking like a female character into the spotlight, so it seems like they're being equal. But when there's actually a well written and strong female protagonist, I think it's good. It's the same with Hunger Games as well.
Exactly.
Katniss Everdeen. It's a strong character, and I enjoy that. I enjoy watching
it. So, Joe, you said that we need more strong female protagonist
and well written and doing it for the right reasons, not for reasons of equality, because
that's really great you say that,
in the final Marvel film, what's it called,
Avengers Endgame,
and everyone comes out, you know, that big scene,
of course.
And it brings everyone out, and then it puts some like uplifting music and all the female heroines come out, and it's like there should be complete equality in genders, but when you can so clearly see they're forcing it to fit some sort of for lack of a better word, quota, I guess, then I just don't like it. But Kill Bill, incredible film. Luke,
I could agree with that.
What would you say is your all-time favourite action / thriller?
I'm going to have to cheat it, Ben, say one for action, one for thriller.
Oh, okay, I'll let you off.
I'm going to have to say Django Unchained for action. The fight scene in the house at the end, it's just quality.
It doesn't surprise me.
From start to finish, I just enjoy that film.
Yeah,
I
really do. Thriller.
For thriller, I'd have to say, it would have to be between, no, it'd have to be Shutter Island.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'd have to be Shutter Island.
Very strong film. Great. All right.
And then we're going to finish on the best Disney film. Joe, initially, what films are coming to your head?
My mum will be listening to this, and she will know my answer. It's Toy Story.
I completely agree. I personally feel the second Toy Story
The one with Zerg. I think that's the best. That's my favourite.
The second one.
Yeah.
And then there's two buzzers.
Yeah. Is that the one with Al's Toy Barn? No, the one two buzzers is the third one.
No.
With the Spanish buzz.
No. No, that's still the same buzz. They just reboot.
I'm completely wrong, everybody.
They go to Al's Toy Barn to get Woody, because they think...
Yeah, I'm happy to concede on that.
And... He goes, Buzz goes that aisle of all the
Buzz Lightyears,
and it's the Buzz Lightyear with the belt.
Yeah,
and he fights him, and then he takes his place.
And then the bouncy balls start going about. But you've probably seen it anyway, guys.
What a film! But Joe, apart from Toy Story, you could say Wall-E.
Do you know what? I don't know about Wall-E. Don't know about Wall-E. If we're talking best Disney Pixar outside of Toy Story, we're talking Incredibles, we're talking Monsters Inc., and probably Ratatouille as well.
I'd say Lion King.
Lion King.
It's not Disney Pixar, but
yeah.
Lion King is a classic Disney cartoon.
What other older sort of Disney films do you think are good?
Yeah, Pinocchio is an absolute classic.
You know what? That actually used to scare me quite a lot.
Scare you?
Yeah, like they took him off to the island and turned him into donkeys, didn't they?
I mean, yeah, I know the book's a bit dodgy, but...
It was creepy.
It is scary.
Jungle Book, that's also got to be up there. Absolute classic.
Absolute classic film. And obviously, I Want to Be Like You.
Oh, cheers, man. Thank you. That's quite nice of you to say.
Nah. From the song from the Jungle Book, I Want to Be Like You.
Oh, right. Do you mean the Slim Gratina remix?
Oh, the jungle VIP. I've reached the top and had to stop, and that's what's bothering me. I wanna be a man cop, and stroll right into town, and be just like the other men. I'm tired of walking around. Oh,
was I Want to Be Like You, the Slim Gratina remix. And we're going to jump right back into the movie debate.
Ooh.
What are we discussing now, Joe?
We're going to go for underrated movies.
Underrated. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to try out something.
Yeah.
I've made a list of movies that I think are underrated. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to read them out to you. And I know you have good movie knowledge, so I'm not going to try and put you down.
Yeah.
But I'm just trying to prove the point of, have you seen these movies that I believe are underrated?
Yeah. All right. And also, can I say that if I haven't seen them, but I think people rate them, then I'll...
Yeah, cool. Yeah, no, you got to give your input.
Cool.
Right. Are you ready?
I am.
The film Prisoners with Hugh Jackman and Jake Gyllenhaal. Have you seen that?
I haven't, no.
It's a very good film. Basically, Hugh Jackman plays a dad, mm-hmm. and his girl goes missing, and he doesn't know how or where she is, and Jake Gyllenhaal is the inspector in this case, and it's a very good thriller.
All right, well, I hope Luke sold it too. Next
there
one,
you
Luke.
Nightcrawler.
No.
That's about Jake Gyllenhaal again. He's a paparazzi, and he goes about LA trying to find the latest story, and that's a very underrated film, I think.
Only Nightcrawler reference I know is from It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. If you know, you know.
If you know, you know. The next one, Star Wars: Rogue One.
Nope.
I believe that's underrated because the Star Wars films obviously get hyped up a lot.
Yep.
That's a good film. The second Hunger Games. You must have seen that.
Yeah, I've seen the second Hunger Games.
Yeah, I think
Games.
It's underrated. Speed.
No.
With Keanu Reeves. No. Very underrated film. That's a classic film.
Yeah, you're explaining the plot to this film to me earlier, and it does sound interesting.
Basically, these terrorists infiltrate this bus, and if the bus goes under 30 miles per hour, it will explode, and Officer Keanu Reeves on the bus, and he comes to the rescue.
I think I might have seen certain takes on that in different things.
Probably,
I think
yeah.
The Simpsons maybe did some sort of cast, maybe family,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
like
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
But yeah,
another one, The Beach with Leonardo DiCaprio.
No,
that's very underrated. You should watch that.
Yeah,
the film Seven with Brad Pitt and Morgan Freeman.
No, is it about is it about the sins, the seven sins? Is it that one?
You have to find out, Joe. Have you seen The Gladiator? I can't believe I'm saying this. A lot of people I know have not seen The Gladiator. Have you seen The Gladiator?
No.
You would love that film.
This also, we haven't actually spoken this through before and checked that I don't know them. Genuinely, I just feel like a bit of a schmuck now.
No, you
like,
don't. You don't. Look, honestly, if anything, it's
look,
good because you can look forward to seeing these films.
And precisely, and I'm saying it with my chest. I haven't watched as many movies as I should have done, but there we go.
Last one I got is World War Z. With Brad Pitt.
I haven't, but also I don't feel like that's underrated. I feel like a lot of people have seen that.
I think that's underrated. A little known fact, my cousin is actually an extra in that film.
Really?
I'm pretty sure
that is probably quite...
They filmed that in Scotland.
Is it?
Would you believe?
I'll
my cousin
what,
is an extra in
that.
That
probably is quite a little known fact.
That is a little known fact. And my last one, have you seen A Prayer Before Dawn?
No, I haven't.
I'm annoyed. I don't actually know the name of the man the film is based off. But his name's Billy. I can't remember his surname.
He did in... podcast with True Jordan.
He did.
He's good.
Liverpudlian, and it's just his life living in Thailand as a Muay Thai fighter.
Yeah, that's one that I've missed.
He sells drugs. It's crazy. And Joe Cole, who's in Peaky Blinders, plays him.
Yeah,
that's really good.
I haven't watched the movie, but I've listened to the podcast about the movie, and his story is crazy. It's crazy.
It is. So those are my underrated films.
But right? Luke, what would you say is your single most underrated film? I'm making you pick, mate, and it's tough.
I'd say Prisoners or The Beach. The Beach is very underrated.
Yeah.
With Leonardo DiCaprio. Very underrated, that film.
Fair enough.
No, okay, I can't. No, I'd pick one. The Beach, I'd say.
I'd probably, I haven't really thought about this. I'm just going to say Austin Powers because it's funny. Next one.
Yeah.
Luke, we're going to move straight on into the worst and most overrated movies.
Worst and most overrated films.
Yes, as you know, it's the part of the show that we don't like. Everyone gets a bit somber, a bit sad, but we have to do it.
We have to do it.
It's the rule of
it's
six,
only,
guys.
It's the rule of six, as Boris Johnson said in the beginning of the show.
Thank you again,
I would
Bojo.
Say one of the worst films.
Yeah.
White Chicks.
Yeah.
I don't find that funny.
I've never
I'm
put
sorry.
Myself through that. And it is basically like reverse blackface.
It is.
It is completely.
But it's like that. What's that reverse card, Nuno?
Oh God!
That is so jokes, Joe. I got your tongue.
Yo, mate. Yo, I'm good. Oh my God!
That's so funny. Right, another one. So White Chicks. We got you agree with me on
yeah,
that one.
Yeah.
Have you seen Batman and Robin with George Clooney?
Yeah, and
that film is
with
shocking.
Arnold Schwarzenegger
as Iceman.
Yeah, and it's got Jim Carrey in as the Riddler. And do you know what? What's her face? What's
Uma Thurman?
Poison Ivy. I used to think she was very attractive in that film. And
And Bane's in that film as well.
Yeah.
And it's a very big progression from that film to Tom Hardy's Bane.
Oh yeah,
for sure. But that film is.
But
just
do you know what it is with
shocking.
That film? I think it's like so bad that it's kind of good. Like it's enjoyable.
It's funny to watch
because it's.
I remember watching it with my brother and my mum, and I just constantly kept laughing.
It's strange how they've got so many big actors into that film.
I know. The lineup is so good.
Yeah,
but they've ruined it so much.
The script and
yeah.
It's all so awful and it looks quite cheap, but they've managed to convince so many actors. to get in on the scene.
Joe, have you seen the Fantastic Four reboot, the Marvel Fantastic Four? It's got Miles Teller, Michael B. Jordan.
No, I haven't.
It's so bad. It's honestly so bad. One of the worst films I've seen. Yeah, and so it's that one. And I say one of the later Transformers films. There's that film, I think 50 Shades.
Yeah.
I don't really get it.
I've never sat and watched the whole thing.
I haven't seen it, but I just...
Yeah, there's just some films that I know that I won't like, so I just don't entertain watching them.
I think those are mine.
Overrated. I've got a couple for overrated that I just thought of.
Go on.
The Greatest Showman. I don't like musicals, so
I think the Greatest Showman is a family film though. Like I know a lot of families would go and watch that and rate that. I think our age, we wouldn't rate those films.
Yeah,
but you got to see it from the perspective of like families, young children. Yeah, who really love that.
But there's still like films for young children that are good. Do you know what I mean?
And you know,
it's just so cliche.
Yeah, it is. And the Greatest Showman like, is based off P.T. Barnum who owned a circus.
Okay.
And it's all, you know, really painted out like it's great in the film, but in real life, he treated the people in his shows really badly.
Yeah.
Like
I just. I know.
Well, supposedly that's what reports have said.
Yeah, I think obviously, I'm going to be biased because.
So you really don't like The Greatest Showman?
No.
Do you have a heart?
No, I don't. I have a heart of ice.
Ice cold.
I remember I watched it in cinema and I just sat there like, I just don't really care.
I would argue that, controversial maybe, mm-hmm. Avatar is very overrated.
Yeah, I think Avatar, it's not a bad film.
It's not a bad film, and it was very advanced for its time.
Yeah, but there's nothing special
now,
about it.
Hopefully, they've been making the second one for years now. Hopefully, that's really good.
I mean, the thing is that sort of the artistic process behind it and some of the
very
scenes
long.
Were
very long.
They were very beautiful, but.
Beautiful.
At the end of the day, it was just very overhyped. Was it, what's his face? James Cameron, was it?
James Cameron, yeah, I believe it is James Cameron who directs those films.
Yeah.
I'd argue Spectre's overrated.
Yeah.
James Bond Spectre.
Probably.
You know, following from Skyfall's can be difficult, but Spectre was just very overrated. I didn't think it was that good of a film.
What about Johnny English Reborn?
Yeah. I don't really think.
To be fair, I guess with a lot of sequels that don't live up to the
original.
Actually,
that was all right. The third one I haven't watched, but the second one looked...
I'll tell you what's bad. It's overrated. I don't know if it was really rated in the first place, but Toy Story 4, I thought 1, 2 and 3 were so strong.
They should have left on 3. Yeah. 3 was a good finish into that like trilogy basically.
Yeah, exactly. But I think it's one of them ones where with the second one it's so difficult to be as good as the first.
I believe the new franchises Jurassic World and Fantastic Beasts are very overrated. We had this discussion briefly earlier and you don't think Fantastic Beasts is a credible film anyway.
Yeah, exactly.
I think because it's got that Harry Potter fan base, it's rated very highly, but I don't think, even though Eddie Redmayne is a great actor and they've got very big names in it, I mean Johnny Depp was in it before.
Yeah, it's quite topical right now.
Very topical, but I just think it's very overrated in my opinion.
Luke, I might ruffle a few feathers here.
Ruffle away, Joe.
Right, that is something I never thought would be said on this radio show, but I will ruffle away. Luke, I think the whole Marvel franchise is overrated. I think the Avengers is overrated. I never fully bought into it.
There's a lot of people who are going to be annoyed at you right now.
There is, but there'll be some...
I get completely where you're coming from.
There'll be some people who agree with me.
I believe that The Dark Knight is the best superhero film ever made, and the only reason Christopher Nolan's style of directing is very, he hates using CGI.
Yeah,
he will limit that as much as possible and he'll just keep things natural, and it's, the plot is very, is more philosophical, whereas I believe with Marvel it's very much, oh, we're here to save the day, CGI, yeah. Massive fight.
Yeah, exactly. It's quite
very, it's more childish, I believe.
It's visually stunning, but there's not really anything to it, if you know what I mean. It's all very you can kind of see what's going to happen. Whereas when a film doesn't tell you how to feel, it lets you make up your own decisions on how you feel about different characters. I think that lends to a much better viewing experience.
And you can argue as well, the Dark Knight actually won an Oscar and the Marvel films have never actually won Oscars.
Yeah, so shut up, Marvel films, all right? Just go home.
Tom Holland, mate. Coming for you.
Oh, all right, Luke. what do you think about the whole Spider-Man multiverse thing? You've told me before that there could be the potential of Andrew Garfield, Tobey Maguire and Tom Holland coming together to do one film.
I believe
three different Spider-Mens from different parallel universes.
Played on that multiverse.
It's an exciting idea.
I believe, I think it actually might happen. I know Tobey Maguire signed on to it. Jamie Foxx has signed on to it. He was from the franchise of Andrew Garfield.
How old is Tobey Maguire now? He must be cracking on a little bit.
Yeah.
But I mean, 40, then again, 40s, it probably doesn't really matter.
I think that's the role he's going for, like a father figure for the Tom Holland Spider-Man. But I hope that it's true. I mean, well, it'd be such a good move from the Marvel and Sony studios because the first two franchises did flop.
Yeah, and also
it'd be great to save it, basically.
The thing is that Tom Holland's character, Spider-Man's, lost his kind of father figure in Tony Stark. So
I mean, they're arguing Doctor Strange, Benedict Cumberbatch could fit in, but it's not the same.
Yeah, don't know.
And as well, I've looked at sources today that say that saying that they might bring back the Green Goblin too.
I thought that was a good character
from like the first franchise.
Really?
Yeah. I can't remember who plays him. Big actor.
Yeah, and he's in American Psycho as well.
Yeah.
You'll know who we're talking about at home. We're not going to waste any more of your time.
But I'm that sounds exciting, and hopefully that does come true.
Luke, another sort of, while we're on this sort of down, negative, somber mood.
So just negative.
The Wizard of Oz. I've got a few actually quite disturbing facts for you here.
Disturbing.
Lined up. Yeah, I mean, have you seen the film
Fire Away,
Wizard of Oz? It's a creepy, creepy film.
Do you know when it came out?
A
while ago.
You tell me. Well, that's very interesting, Luke. These facts are according to BuzzFeed. Okay, so don't hold us accountable. Allegedly.
Fire away, Joe.
The green makeup used for Margaret Hamilton,
who played Dorothy.
Played the Wicked.
That was so stupid.
There we go. You said it with such confidence as well. You made a schmuck of yourself. The green makeup used for Margaret Hamilton's costume was so toxic that she was on a strict liquid diet whilst filming, and actually caused her burns to her face as well. How horrible is that?
That's crazy.
What?
All right, next one.
What? So MGM, who I presume helped produce the movie.
Yeah.
Hired attendants to help the little people on and off the studio toilets because one of the munching actors got stuck in a toilet for 45 minutes.
45 minutes?
And these munchkin actors, right, they were quite pesky.
They're quite pesky. What'd they do?
A lot of them actually got arrested between shoots, and they were so bad that they had to have an MGM employee that was literally assigned to watch over them. And quite disgustingly,
I know what you're going to say.
That they would put their hands up Dorothy's skirts during shoots.
That's actually,
it's disturbing.
Yeah, that doesn't sit well with me, Joe.
Buddy Ebsen was the original Tin Man, but the aluminium dust from the makeup nearly killed him, and he had to be replaced by Jack Haley.
Why are you doing this? Making me feel down.
Is
there any more disturbing? Are there any more?
The dog got stepped on and had to be replaced.
Replace in what way?
Just replace.
just say replace.
The snow.
You want to replace.
The snowstorm. The snowstorm.
I know this one. Yeah, the snowstorm.
Easy for me to say. That took place in the poppy field scene was actually asbestos falling on the actors.
I can't believe that. That one's crazy.
Betty Danko, the Wicked Witch's stunt double, spent 11 days in hospital after a pipe in the character's broomstick exploded.
Jeez.
The studio executives at MGM treated Judy Garland, who I believe played Dorothy, so terribly that they often referred to her as a fat little pig with pigtails. Quite mean. And she was forced to have a strict diet of chicken soup,
I've heard this,
black coffee and cigarettes, along with pills to reduce her appetite.
I can't believe that.
Clara Blandick, who played Aunt Em, committed suicide later at the age of 85.
Yeah, but that doesn't really have any relevance to
Margaret Hamilton, aka the Wicked Witch of the West, suffered second degree burns on her face and third degree burns on her hands after a stunt went wrong.
With the fire?
Yep.
Fire scene, wow.
So there's, one more. The Cowardly Lion costume, worn by the Cowardly Lion, was made of real lion hair.
So many things wrong.
It's just a very creepy movie. I don't like the vibe.
Sounds
from
very
that cursed. Movie.
So not overrated, but in terms of worst for production and behind the scenes.
Yeah, true.
You could argue that probably is the worst film.
We'll say it is. Just a very generally creepy movie all round. But Luke, let's raise the spirits a little bit.
Should we chuck on a song?
Let's chuck on a song from a film that is not overrated.
No, absolutely not. Brilliant film. It's Black Panther. And this is All the Stars by Kendrick Lamar featuring SZA. I think that's how it's said.
Kendrick, we're on to spontaneous questions. Luke, do you want me to kick off?
Kick off. Yes.
So my spontaneous question for you, Lukey Ball. If I had to direct a film, what would it be about? It's a loaded question, Luke.
I'd actually keep it relevant and keep it in Birmingham.
Okay.
Have you seen many films that are filmed in Birmingham? Obviously, there has been films filmed in Birmingham, but any major blockbuster.
What's your top 10 favourite films filmed in Birmingham?
Exactly.
There we go.
So I'd film in Birmingham.
What would it be?
Maybe we'll do about us, the come up of our radio show.
Yeah, true.
How we took over the world.
Wow. Yeah, I quite like that.
And that'd be based on a true story as well, so it means something. And then people go, did that actually happen? And we're like, yeah.
Yeah, or we could just give them a nod, just be like,
don't tell anyone, but it happened.
No, I quite like, I think that's a good idea, to be fair, mate. And I hope you'd let me co-direct with you.
I'll have a think about it.
Who would you play? Should we play each other in it? Just spice it up a little bit.
I'd play you, yeah. That'd be quite funny. Not a bad idea. Yeah, but if we're older,
yeah,
would we play ourselves?
True.
And you can't even ask that question of who would play you.
Because I don't know.
Because we can't tell what the future generational talent will be.
Who do you think could put in a good performance of you? Just forget age. Who would you have to play yourself?
Who would you cast to play me?
I could give you an answer that I know you'd like to hear.
What?
Do you know what I'd go for? I'd go for Gary Barlow.
That's not funny.
I don't know if you
No,
guys...
who would you say it? I'll get gassed by it. You've got to say it now.
No,
say it. Who would play me? Say it. Don't be like this.
No,
tell me
I'm
who you're thinking.
I'm just thinking.
No, because you obviously had a good one.
Yeah, but I'm between two. Oh, no, I'll just go for it. I'd say Tom Hardy, just because that'd gas you.
No, I don't think Tom Hardy could play me.
You don't think he can play you?
We don't look similar and we're not like each other
Michael
at all.
That's why I said
Do you know who I've been told I look like?
Gary Barlow.
I've been told I look like Gary Barlow. Don't see it at all. But apparently I look like Sam Coughlin.
Don't know who he is.
The guy from Hunger Games.
Which one?
Fennec? He plays Fennec or something? I don't know. I could have butchered that. Sam Coughlin?
No, let me quickly just look him up.
What, are you still recording?
Sam, what's his name?
Coughlin.
Coughlin?
Coughlin, yeah. No, Coughlin.
Coughlin?
Coughlin, yeah, I look like him. I look like him with like 10 years' time.
Coughlin?
Yes.
I
don't know, mate.
Nah, I think you're tooting your own horn a little bit there, mate. I think you're getting
I've been
excited.
Told to look him, but I don't.
You've definitely thought... I'm so good looking. I look exactly like him. And you're
painting me out in a very bad light.
Well, you're painting out that people have been calling you Sam Coughlin when they.
Well, do you know who I get to play you?
You're gonna mug me off because I pissed you off.
The guy from the Goonies.
Yeah, fair enough, mate. Good. Do you know who I'd have to play me? It's one of them. It'd be a difficult role, I think.
It'd be a complex role.
Yeah, I'm just trying to think.
Oscar worthy.
Probably Zac Efron. Probably.
Do you think you can seriously pull off Joey Camp, Zac Efron?
He'd struggle, but I liked his how he played Ted Bundy, so that's why I'd probably give it to him.
Well, really?
Yeah, I thought he acted well in that.
To be fair, a lot of Zac Efron films after he did Oscar Musical were actually kind of underrated.
You think so?
Yeah, some of them were.
Baywatch.
I think Baywatch just wasn't good. I thought that was overrated actually. If anything. Yeah. But he has done like smaller films since that are actually pretty underrated. But that was your question to me. My question to you, Joe. Can you do an impression of a character from one of your favourite films?
It's a good one. I can do the scene from The Dark Knight. You know, the one where the Joker's hanging, what's her face? Can't remember Batman's wifey.
Oh, that's really annoying. I know her name.
Anyway, the one where he's hanging her out the window. So.
Jake Gyllenhaal's sister. Don't know what her name is.
Goes a bit like this.
Go on.
Let her go. Very poor choice of words.
You sound a bit like Yoda.
Yeah, I did a little bit. Right, okay. Scrap that. Can't do the Joker. Alternatively, we could play our audition tapes from 2012, you know, the ones for the Dark Knight Rises.
Oh, yeah. You sure you want to play that?
Yeah, the ones we sent off to Christopher Nolan. He never got back to us, kind of. It's kind of
yeah, lonely, Chris.
But, yeah, chuck them on.
I just want to know if Chris can get back to us, but yeah, sure, let's chuck it on.
Yeah, after hearing this, I'm sure he will.
This is Luke Bull auditioning for the role of Bane.
And Joseph Camp auditioning for the role of Batman.
Not as serious as yours, I fear.
Bane.
Let's not stand on ceremony here, Mr. Wayne. Patience costs us time. victory has defeated you. Your decadency and deception. Powerful agents to the initiated. But we are initiated, aren't we, Bruce? Members of the League of Shadows. And you betrayed us.
Yes. You were excommunicated by a gang of psychopaths.
I am the League of Shadows. I'm here to fulfill Ra's al Ghul's destiny. You fight like young man. Nothing held back. Honorable, but mistaken. You think darkness is your ally, but you merely adopt the dark. I was born in it, molded by it. I didn't see the light until I was already a man. By then it was nothing to me but blood. The shadows betray you because they belong to me.
Thank you very much for listening, Chris. We both eagerly wait your response. And also, while we're here, Luke was wondering if you had Tom Hardy's phone number, but no worries if
it's
you
not
don't.
Big deal.
Yeah, thank you. Well, what an absolute treat that was.
That was something special.
I haven't heard that for a while, actually.
I feel like, as an actor, it was challenging. It made me think. Do you know what, mate? Constantly.
I think you've been a bit cheated there. I don't know why they gave the role to Tom Hardy, but they
I feel
did.
Very cheated. And what could have been?
The fact that Christopher Nolan didn't even have the
And to be fair, Joe, to be fair, I definitely bench more than what Tom Hardy would have benched at that time as well.
Oh yeah.
He looked pretty small. The rig was not in good shape.
Yeah, he could have tried a bit better, but I think that just comes down to laziness, if I'm honest.
It is laziness.
But right,
Joe, what is the last song of the show today?
Of the show is an absolute banger. It's from The Interview. It is Bam Bam by Sister Nancy.
What a tune.
I think I'm a bum bum, the little whistle arms on me a can, little different style, different fashion, you know? Tell me, say one thing, Nancy, if you understand. One thing, Nancy, if you understand. One thing, them a talk about me ambition. Say one make who them a talk about me ambition. Come and say some of them a ask me where me get it from. Tell some of them a ask me where me get it from. I told them no, it's from creation. I told them no, it's from creation. Bam, bam, ayo, what a bam. Bam, 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 bam beg you go. I know it from me X street down to my toe. I teach I don't, sister Nancy on the go. And some of them are ask, sister Nancy make you bad so. Long down the list, sister Nancy make you bad so. He bam bam, what a bam bam. He bam bam the long, bam bam. He bam bam the long, bam bam. What a bam bam. Hey yo, tell me say what a bam bam. This woman, I never trouble no one. I'm a lady, I'm not a man. MC is my ambition. I come feel nice up Jamaican. So bam bam, say what a bam bam. Bam bam de lang, bam bam. Bam bam de lang, bam bam, 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 bam. Hey, tell me say one thing Nancy can understand. One thing Nancy can understand.
Thank you very much, Sister Nancy. Very kind of you to perform that for us on the radio.
And thank you very much, guys, for listening to this week's show.
Thank you. Feel like we did chat a bit of Wass. It did maybe derail at some point.
It was a hard topic. It was a hard topic.
It was enjoyable.
Address.
Also, tell us what you thought of the intro. That little bit of banter about me plugging Instagram and the Bane and Batman scene, because, you know, we thought we'd up the production a little bit.
A lot of work has been going into this episode.
I thought it was quite funny. And that intro got me gassed.
Yeah, me too. Me too. But if you want to see even more content and you want to tune into our extra time, please do follow our page on Instagram. That is @_RO6. That is @_RO6 Instagram.
Big things to come. Cheers, guys.
Thank you very much for listening. We'll see you next week.